just the way I feel. Mine's been racing so long, yeah. It's just no way to deal with these problems alone. And I really can't take it no more. I've been by temptations, my lord. I'm young and I'm restless, and I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Now everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling and I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just wanna see my people in power. Tell me how we gon' shape this vision. Complaining all day but in the same condition. If you wanna make change, it's gon' take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental prisons. When I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on and listen.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Ahead, we've got a couple of AFC Pro Bowlers from a season ago set to square off. It's DeMarco Murray and Jay Ajayi.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and to the newly renovated Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their Dolphins emerging from the Hard Rock Stadium tunnels, and we're ready to go as the Dolphins get set to match up with Marcus Mariota and the Tennessee Titans. Short boot, taken at the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down. So second and 10 here. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
This defense now can make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. Throwing on third down, Tannehill. And he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down.
Now that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Here's Jackson. A beautiful fake. A terrific return. 30 yards all in all. And it'll be Titan football. It's Murray. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Second down following the run. To throw is Mariota. They will find the rookie from Western Kentucky, Taywan Taylor. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A really good pickup of 28 yards. First down, Mariota. He's going to loft one deep, and this is taken in at the 5. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized. Executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play.
And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. DeMarco Murray, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Titans have taken a first quarter lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now here's Suck about to kick it away. Jakeem Grant now to return. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out of a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened.
Jay Ajayi's going to go. And they finally bring him down, but he reaches the 16. A big play that time for the Dolphins. 63 yards on the ground. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. They run again with Ajayi. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second in just about a few inches here. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. A first carry now. This is Williams. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. They give them 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They'll try and run. This is Williams. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. On second down, Williams. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. A nice run there as he picks up 6. It's going to be 3rd and goal now.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. He loses 4, and it brings up 4.
Brandon, I believe that they were in four down territory, and that's what they were thinking. But after the loss, I've got to kick the field goal. No way I'm going to go for it in this situation. But you know, some of these coaches, they're extremely unpredictable, and they may go ahead and press it.
Back to throw, Tannehill. And my goodness, this is incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Titans defense will celebrate the goal line stand. And not great starting field position here for the offense. Here's Murray now as they run it to start the drive. And he'll be taken down for a loss back at the three.
All right, partner, despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance, and it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
That was second down run for Murray. And he's going to take this up past the 10 to about the 11. And he's able to get more than half of what they needed. That brings up a third and five.
No other way to say it, but it was an off year for DeMarco Murray in Philadelphia, and Chip Kelly's offense didn't really seem to be a fit. But when he went to Tennessee playing for Mike Mularkey, boy, did he fit in a big way.
Finished third in the NFL in rushing behind Ezekiel Elliott and a late-charging Jordan Howard. He was ahead of Howard much of the year.
I remember Coach Mularkey in preseason said, DeMarco Murray's my number one back. He'll get plenty of carries here, and he did.
And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now a give. This is Murray. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through him.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. They'll try to throw now. Mariota. All going deep here for Taylor. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on. Third down.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
On third down, Mariota. And Davis with it left side. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. In his 10th year, here's Brett Kern to punt this one. The dangerous Jarvis Landry back for Miami. Now Landry. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And it'll be Dolphin football. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Well, simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
Double tight, guys. Double tight. Tannehill going to throw on third and one. And he's got his man. That's Landry. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 41-yard line. Tannehill to Landry. Good for a Dolphin first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And some room to run now. Past the 20. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A big play on the ground there. It goes for 36 yards. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get it behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make it third and goal. They'll fake the handoff. Now Tannehill. Blitz coming and down he goes.
Third and goal, they decided to throw for it, but how about the play defensively? Couldn't find anyone open, left him nowhere to go with the football, had to absorb the sack.
Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. This just a 35-yard attempt from the left hash. And Parkey's kick is good. And they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
Yeah, as an offensive coordinator, if you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work. But in his defense, this has been a stifling defense so far. So they've got to start finding a way to unlock them as this game goes on.
And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And coming up later tonight in the NFL, we'll have the Chiefs heading down to Houston to take on the Texans. And then on Monday night, it'll be an NFC North battle. Vikings and Bears from Soldier Field.
Traditional rivals getting after it one more time.
They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. They go with Murray again. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Here's the former Heisman winner. It's Derrick Henry. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he's going to be met at about the 43. It'll be called a gain of two, and that'll leave them with some options here on fourth and inches.
I bet they thought they had picked that one up because it was a third and two call. And they got awfully close. Now we're at fourth and inches. I wonder if they think they're feeling lucky here and maybe want to go pick it up.
Henry, and he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. They'll give him a yard on the play, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. For Mariota, dancing to his left. There he goes inside the 30. And he's going to go out of bounds. He takes this one down shy of the 20. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. A first update now from Cleveland. The Jets out to the early lead. Josh McCown, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. Carry for Henry, and running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. First down and more. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. DeMarco Murray with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. And oh, it's no good. For the second time now in this first half, he's missed an extra point. Suck about to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Dolphins offense now ready to go back out onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. And at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Here's Tannehill, buying time to his left. Now he's going to throw deep into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's the rookie from USC, Adoree Jackson. Time to step aside. We'll come back to Miami after this. The interception here. Mariota escaping the pressure right. Touchdown, Tennessee! Well, the defensive coverage was good, so good he just decided to make a play of his own, and it worked out.
Yeah, you often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? But I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that, and he beat him on that play all the way to the end zone.
Now here's Suck about to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And out come the Dolphins now.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful.
And that's caught inside the 30. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Looking for Landry, and it's intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard, and he is all the way up past the 25.
So that's back-to-back drives where they don't an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Mariota on first down. Flush to his right. And he's got some space here. Space to maneuver at the 40. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
On first and 10, here's Mariota. Uncorks one for Davis. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
He's going to let one go deep for Parker. And this will be caught at the 30. A big play there just before halftime. 54 yards.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Forced out to his left. The swing pass caught, and he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about. Play fake to Ajayi. It's Tannehill. Out to his left. He's going to look deep now for Landry. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. 46 yards on the boot. The coverage holds him to just 3 on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number 2. And someone must have been in this hot sun a little too long. They've got the punt team out there. And just to clarify, it is not fourth down. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number 2. And someone must have been in this hot sun a little too long. They've got the punt team out there. And just to clarify, it is not fourth down. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. So we reach halftime here with the visiting Titans taking...
And before we could even hear from Larry, we're back and ready to go in week five. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. Their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
A play fake to Murray. Now Mariota. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
On third down, Murray. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. It's a pickup of six, but it's not going to be enough. And the punt team's going to be summoned on fourth down.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let him outside where they can really shred your defense.
On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. Landry now on the return, and he'll be knocked down sideways. The good kick, 48 yards, four on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Coming and he's taken down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not gonna fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
Now Tannehill, and he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked by Kevin Byard, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up.
I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is taken at his four. Now a hit and a loose football. It's picked up by the Titans. And this drive will start on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Now a second down throw for Mariota. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A Tennessee first down, that one Mariota to Matthews. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it, because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic, and people wanting to put a little contact on him. Really well done.
And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Here's Mariota. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Here's Tannehill now on second down. Being chased out left. Now he's going to let it go. Got a man. It's Landry for the Dolphins touchdown. Jarvis Landry, his second touchdown on the season. And thanks to the interception, the Dolphins offense cashes in with six. Here's Tannehill. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the veteran, Brian Arakpo. He's at the 50, the 40, the 20, 10, 5, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. Here's Parkey now set to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
They go back to Murray on first down. And down inside the 40 to about the 38. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. On second down, here's Henry. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. A 3-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. They'll run it again with Henry. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Mariota now to throw on first down. And an alley to run. Tennessee getting the first down on a big play of 18 yards.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he will score. Touchdown. Titans. DeMarco Murray, his third touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. Now, these have been no picnic for him so far. He's missed two, but this one is good. Now here's Suckabout to kick it away. This is taken at his four. Spinning past him. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So now here come the Dolphins. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Jonathan Cyprian. And they will finally bring this run back to an end, but not before he's down inside the 5-yard line at the 4. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that from the Painter.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score? Cameron Wake makes plays like that look simple because I think he plays with excellent leverage. Really does a nice job of being lower than the offensive guys trying to block him. He gets underneath them and goes up and down the line of scrimmage to make those types of plays.
And kept him to a short run play there. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it's third and goal. And this offense on third down today, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and goal. They'll sneak it with Mariota. And he gets halfway there down to the 1-yard line. He needed 2. He only got 1 on the sneak, and that's going to lead us to a 4th and 1. Here's Ryan Succop for the Titan field goal. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And Succop will put this one right through, and that will push the lead up from 26, and it grows up to 29. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for 6, but they do get 3.
And I know in this situation, most of us want to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit, taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
You think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34. Here. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Well, he appears well on his way to another big game. You remember 2016, partner. He became just the 4th player in NFL history to have 3 200-yard rushing games in a season.
2 of them were back-to-back. Steelers in week 6, Bills in week 7. Back now in Miami. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. Fresh set of downs here.
Double tight, guys. Double tight.
Come on, let's go!
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. So a loss of 5, and it'll be 2nd down. Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day, and sometimes that just happens. It is the NFL. They will make some plays against you.
After the run, Tannehill going to throw. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for 4th.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, but what a nice job improvising, finding other options, and completing the pass anyway.
His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. And the Titans getting set to go. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. You know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out. But for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
A 20th carry coming up now for Murray. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up 2nd. To the 33. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the 4th quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
1st and 2nd down were a disaster. Both went backwards. Now it's 3rd and 18. They need something big. Derrick Henry. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a 6-yard gain, and it leaves him looking at a 4th down.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall at the 16. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time. You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Tannehill now to throw. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
And a loss of 3 to bring up 4th. Here's Jacob Shum now, standing just outside his own goal line. With it is Jackson. 44-yard punt. They're going to wind up losing yardage on the return, though. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. On 1st down, Murray. Nifty move. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time. And that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. Again, it's Murray. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be 3rd down. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. On 3rd down. That's Murray looking for an opening. Not much there. He'll get it to the 39. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And that will come the offense as they take over. They'll start out on the ground with a Ajayi. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your...
Ajayi hit. He lost the football. And he'll take this down inside the 15-yard line. He's now lost fumbles in back-to-back weeks. And, of course, you remember last week's game, such a close affair. That hurt him.
Hurt him in a big way, and it is so key to take care of the ball because, remember, the team making the fewest mistakes usually wins the game. So you got to take care of the ball. Lock it away high and tight, as you often hear from running back coaches. 4 points of pressure. Fingertips, forearm, biceps, sternum, or chest. Put it away.
A good pickup there. 7 yards, and it's going to be 2nd and goal now. Following the penalty, it's Murray. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
Well, they made the play there, and I'll guarantee you their coaches and the other players are screaming at them about their pride. Come on, guys. He's already gotten in 3 times, and you can't give up a 4th one. And on that play, they were able to make the stop.
And you knew they were going to go to him to try to get that 4th.
And why wouldn't they? It's not just getting the 4th. He's the hot hand, so to speak, right? The hot feet in this situation. And he knows how to find the end zone. That time, he just didn't get there.
A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for the Titans, they move a step closer to 500 as their record improves to 2-3. And they'll return home next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for Miami, they'll drop down to 1-3. And they'll try to turn it around next week as they head to Atlanta for a matchup with the Falcons.
I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. I got hustle, though ambition flow inside my DNA. I was born like this, and sworn like this, immaculate conception. I transform like this, perform like this with new weapon. I don't contemplate, I meditate, then off your head. This that put the kids to bed. This that I got realness. I just killed this, cause it's in my DNA. I got millions, I got riches building in my DNA. I got dark, I got evil that rot inside my DNA. I got off, I got trouble, some heart inside my DNA. I just win again, then win again, like Wimbledon I serve. Yeah, that's him again, the sound, the engine in is like a bird. You see fireworks and Corvette tires skirt the boulevard. I know how you work, I know just who you are. See, use a you almost probably switch inside your DNA. Problem is, all that inside your DNA. Daddy probably snitch, heritage inside your DNA. Backbone don't exist, burn on side a jellyfish, I gauge. See my pedigree, most definitely don't tolerate the front. Like been through, probably offend you, this is Parler's oldest son. I know conviction, burners, boosters, ballers, dead. Redemption, scholars, fathers, kids and I wish spared. Forgiveness, yeah. Soldier's DNA, born inside the beast. My expertise checked out in second grade. When I was 9, on sale hotel, we didn't have nowhere to stay. At 29, I've done so well, hit cartwheel in my estate. And I'm gon' shine like I'm supposed to. Antisocial, extrovert, and excellent mean an extra work. And absentness, you hurt. And passiveness never struck my nerve. And that's a riff from the biggest case. The reason my power's here. Salute the truth from the prophet, say I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA.
This is why I say that hip-hop has done more damage to young African-Americans
than
recent years.
I live about my DNA. This is my heritage, all I'm inheriting. Money and power, the Mecca Emeritus. Tell me something, you can't tell me nothing. I'd rather do than to listen to you. My DNA not for imitation. Your DNA an abomination. This how it is when you in the matrix. Dodging bullets, reaping what...